Good morning, children. Sai Ram. So, how are you all? So, I hope you all are fine. Yes. So, are you all ready for today's maths class? Yes. So, in the last class, we have started revising the multiplication chapter, isn't it? So, today let's continue that. Okay. So, first one is multiplication of two-digit numbers. Okay, so we are going to multiply two-digit numbers. Okay, see the first example. So we are going to multiply 27 and 15. 27 and 15. So both the numbers are two-digit numbers, isn't it? So we are going to multiply 27 and 15. Okay. So from where we have to start? So we have to start from ones place, isn't it? So from right side to left, we have to multiply. Okay. First, let's multiply the multiplicand by ones digit of the multiplier. Okay. So 5. So let's start multiplying with 5. Multiply by 5. Okay. So first one is 5 into 7. 5 sevens are? Think and tell me. 5 sevens are 35. Isn't it? 5 sevens are 35. So write 5 here and carry over 3 to the next place. Okay. And now multiply 5 and 2. 5 twos are 10. Isn't it? 5 twos are 10 plus this carried over number. So 10 plus 3 is 13. 10 plus 3 is 13. So we can directly write 13 because there is no number in hundreds place, isn't it? So again, now we have to multiply the tens digit of the multiplier. Isn't it? Multiply the multiplicand by tens digit of the multiplier. So before start multiplying, we have to write 0 in the ones place. Okay? Because we are going to multiply this 27 by tens digit. Tens digit of the multiplier, isn't it? So we have to write 0 in the ones place. Okay. Now let's start multiplying. Okay. So multiply 1 and 7. 1 sevens are 7. And now multiply 1 into 2. 1 twos are 2. Okay. And now we are going to add these two numbers. Okay. Shall we add? Yes. So add 5 plus 0. 5 plus 0 is 5. The next one is 3 plus 7. 3 plus 7. So 7 in the mind, 3 in the finger. After 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 is a 2-digit number. So write 0 here. Carry over 1 to the next place. Okay. Now we have to add 3 numbers, isn't it? So 1 plus 1 is 2 and 2 plus 2 is 4. So the answer is 405. Okay, children. The answer is 405. Have you all understood? Yes. Shall we do one more problem? Yes. The next one is 68 into 42. 68 into 42. So from where we have to start? From ones place, isn't it? So start multiplying. First 2 into 8. 2 into 8. 2 eights are? 2 eights are? 16. Isn't it? 2 eights are 16. So write 6 here. carry over 1 to the next place. Okay. And now multiply 2 into 6. 2 6 are 12. 2 6 are 12. And now add this carried over number. So 12 plus 1, which is equal to 13. 12 plus 1, which is equal to 13. Okay. So we can write 13 here. So before start multiplying the tens digit, what we have to do? We have to write 0 in the ones place. Okay. And now we can multiply. First 4 into 8. 4 8s are 32. 4 8s are 32. 32 is a 2 digit number. So write 2 here and carry over this 3 to the next place. Okay. And now multiply 4 into 6. 4 6 are 24. 4 6 are 24 plus this carried over number 3. Add. So 4 plus 3 is 7. 2. So 27. So write 27 here. Okay. Now add these two numbers. So 6 plus 0 is 6. 3 plus 2 is 5. 1 plus 7 is 8. And write 2 here. So the answer is 2856. Okay. So please remember, when you multiply the tens digit of the multiplier, you have to write 0 in the ones place. Okay. And then start multiplying and write the answer before this 0. Okay. Have you all understood, children? Yes. So shall we move on to the next one? Yes. Next one is shortcut method of multiplying a 2-digit number by a 1-digit number. So we are going to use a shortcut method to multiply 2-digit number by 1-digit number. Okay. See the first example. Find 55 into 7. So 55 is a 2-digit number. 7 is a 1-digit number. Okay. So we can use the shortcut method. Okay. So how to solve? See the solution. So break 55 into 15 and 5. So 55 can be written as 50 plus 5. So if we add 50 plus 5, we get 55, isn't it? So 55 can be written as 50 plus 5. Okay. 55 can be written as 50 and 5. Now we are going to multiply this 50 into 7 and 5 into 7. And we are going to add these two products. Okay. So instead of multiplying 55 into 7, we are going to split this 55 into 50 plus 5. Okay. And the next step, we have to multiply this 50 into 7 and this 5 into 7. Okay. And in the third step, we are going to add these two products. Okay. Then we will get the answer. Okay. So multiply 50 and 5 separately by 7. Okay. So 50 into 7. So we have to write the 0 here and multiply 5 into 7. 5 sevens are 35. So write the 35 before this 0. So the answer is 350. Okay. And now multiply 5 into 7. So 5 sevens are 35. Okay. And now we are going to add these two products. Okay. So add the two products to get the answer. So add 350 and 35. 350 and 35. So add 0 plus 5 is 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. 3. So the answer is 385. Is it clear, children? So this is the final answer. So instead of multiplying 55 into 7, we are going to split 55 into 50 and 5. Okay? And then multiply separately by 7. And in the last step, add the two products. Okay? Then we will get the final answer. Okay, children? Shall we see one more example? Yes. Multiply 64 into 5 using shortcut method. So 64 is a 2-digit number and 5 is a 1-digit number. So we can use shortcut method. Okay. If both numbers are 2-digit numbers, then we cannot use shortcut method. Okay. So multiplicand should be 2-digit number and multiplier should be 1-digit number. Then only we can use the shortcut method. Okay. So in the first step, what we have to do? We have to split this 64 into 60 plus 4. Okay. And now multiply. We are going to multiply 5, isn't it? So multiply 60 into 5 and 4 into 5. Okay. And in the last step, we are going to add these two products to get the final answer. Okay, children, see the solution. Break 64 into 60 and 4 such that 60 plus 4 is equal to 64. Multiply 60 and 4 separately by 5. So first multiply 60 into 5. 60 into 5. So write the 0 here and multiply 6 into 5. 6 5s are 30. So write the 30 before the 0. So the answer is 300. Okay, and now multiply this 4 into 5. 4 5s are 20. Okay, and now we are going to add these two products. That is 300 plus 20. So add 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 2 is 2, 3. So the final answer is 320. Okay? Is it clear? Yes. The next one is estimating products. Estimating products. Okay? So for this, we are going to round off the given numbers to the nearest 10. Okay, see the first example. Estimate 73 into 10, sorry 9. 73 into 9. Okay, see the solution. To estimate the product, round off this 73 to the nearest 10. Since 9 is a single digit number, 1-digit number, so we need not round off this number to the nearest 10. Okay, so we have to round off this 73 to nearest 10. So how to round off this 73 into nearest 10? So it can be rounded off to 70, isn't it? Because 73 is less than 75. So it can be rounded off to 70. Okay, so 73 rounded off is equal to 70. Okay. Now we are going to multiply the 70 into 9. Okay. So 70 into 9. So write this 0 in the last, at the end. And now multiply this 7 into 9. 9 sevens are 63. So write that 63 before this 0. So the answer is 630. Okay. So the product 73 into 9 will be approximately 630. Okay. So to find estimated product, we have to round off the given numbers to the nearest 10. And then we have to multiply. Okay. So for this problem, we can find out actual product. Shall we? Yes. So given numbers are 73 into 9, isn't it? 73 into 9. So we are going to multiply. Okay. So first start from the ones place. Multiply 9 into 3. 9 threes are 27, isn't it? 9 threes are 27. So write this 7 in the answer. Carry over this 2 to the next place. Okay, 2 to the next place. And now multiply 9 sevens are 63. Isn't it? 9 sevens are 63. And add this carried over number 2. So 3 plus 2 is 5, 6. So 65. So the actual product is 657. Okay, children. So to find the estimated product, we have to round off the given numbers to the nearest 10. And then we have to multiply those numbers, okay, to get the estimated product. Okay. So shall we see one more example? Yes. The second one is estimate 62 into 27. So we have to round off 62 and 27 to the nearest 10. Okay. So 62 can be rounded off to 60. Because 62 is less than 65, isn't it? So 62 can be rounded off to 60. Okay. And now 27 can be rounded off to 30. Because 27 is greater than 25. So 27 can be rounded off to 30. Okay. And now multiply these two numbers, 60 and 30. So here two zeros are there. So write two zeros at the end. And now multiply the remaining numbers. Here 6 is there. Here 3 is there. So multiply 6 and 3. 6 threes are 18. So write that 18 before these two zeros. Okay. So the estimated product is 1800. Is it clear, children? So shall we find out the actual product? Yes. So for to find actual product, we are going to multiply 62 into 27. 62 into 27. So starting from the ones place. So multiply 7 into 2. 7 twos are 14, isn't it? 7 twos are 14. So write 4 in the answer and carry over this one to the next place. Now multiply 6 sevens are. 6 sevens are 42. 6 sevens are 42 plus 1 is 43. This carried over number. So 42 plus 1 is 43. So we can write 43. So before multiplying the tens digit of the multiplier, what we have to do? We have to write 0 in the ones place. Isn't it? And now start multiplying 2 into 2. 2 twos are 4. 2 twos are 4. And now 6 into 2. 6 twos are 12. 6 twos are 12. So the actual product is, so this is wrong. So the actual product is, now we are going to add these two numbers. So 4 plus 0 is 4. 3 plus 4 is 7. 4 plus 2 is 6. And write 1 here. Okay. So the actual product is 1674. Okay. The actual product is 1674. Is it clear, children? Yes. Now we shall see the word problems. Okay. So first one is, one bird has two legs. One bird has two legs. And how many legs do four birds have? How many legs do four birds have? So they have given one bird has two legs. So we have to find out how many legs do four birds have. So how to find? So one bird has two legs. Then four bird has 4 × 2 legs, isn't it? See the solution. One bird has two legs. We are going to find out the legs for four birds. Isn't it? The total legs the four birds having is equal to 2 legs × 4. So 4 × 2 = 8. So how many legs? 8 legs. So how many legs do four birds have? Four birds have 8 legs. Okay. The next one. Restaurant purchases 16 boxes of ketchup sachets. Each box contains 96 sachets. How many ketchup sachets in total did the restaurant purchase? Okay. A restaurant purchases 16 boxes of ketchup sachet. Okay. 16 boxes. So in each box, how many sachets are there? 96 sachets. Okay. So we are going to find out the total number of sachets. Okay. So total number of boxes 16. And in each box, 96 sachets are there. So how many sachets are there? We have to find out. For that, what we have to do? We have to multiply this 16 × 96. Okay. See the solution. Number of packets of ketchup in one box is 96. How many boxes are there totally? 16 boxes, isn't it? So number of packets of ketchup in 16 boxes. So they have given number of packets in one box is 96. So now we are going to find out number of packets of ketchup in 16 boxes. For that we have to multiply 96 × 16. Okay, 96 × 16. So shall we multiply 96 × 16? So 96 × 16. Multiply 6 × 6 = 36. 6 × 6 = 36. So write 6 here and carry over 3 to the next place. And now multiply 96. 9 × 6. 9 × 6 = 54. So add 54 plus this carried over number. So if we add, we'll get 57. So write 57. So before start multiplying the tens digit of the multiplier, we have to write 0 in the ones place. Okay. And now multiply 1 × 6. 1 × 6 = 6. And 1 × 9 = 9. So now add these two numbers. 6 plus 0 is 6. And 7 plus 6 is 13. So write 3 here and carry over 1 to the next place. And 1 plus 5 is 6. 6 plus 9 is 15. So the total number of packets is 1536. Okay. So the number of packets of ketchup in 16 boxes is 1536. Is it clear, children? Yes. The next one. Honey purchased 4 kg mangoes costing rupees 35 per kg. Honey purchased 4 kg mangoes. Okay. And it cost rupees 35 per kg. Okay. She also purchased 2 boxes of strawberry, costing rupees 65 per box. She also purchased 2 boxes of strawberry, costing rupees 65 per box. How much did she pay in all? So we have to find out how much 4 kgs of mangoes will cost, and then how much 2 boxes of strawberry cost. Okay, and then we have to add those two amounts. Okay, see the solution. Cost of 1 kg mangoes. So cost of mangoes is rupees 35 per kg, isn't it? So cost of 1 kg mangoes is rupees 35. So how many kgs she buys? 4 kg of mangoes, isn't it? So 1 kg costs rupees 35. So we are going to find out for 4 kgs. Okay. So cost of 4 kg of mangoes is equal to this rupees 35 into 4. So multiply 35 into 4. 5 fours are 20. 5 fours are 20. So write 0 here and carry over 2 to the next place. 3 fours are 12. 12 plus 2 is 14. So the cost of 4 kg of mangoes is rupees 140. Okay, rupees 140. And now we are going to find out the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry. Okay, so what is the cost of strawberry for 1 box? Rupees 65, isn't it? So we have to find out the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry. For that, what we have to do? We have to multiply this 65 into 2. Isn't it? See, cost of 1 box of strawberry is rupees 65. So we have to find out cost of 2 boxes of strawberries, isn't it? For that we have to multiply 65 into 2. Okay. So 65 into 2. So multiply 65 into 2. So 5 twos are 10. 5 twos are 10. So write 0 here. Carry over 1 to the next place. 6 twos are 12. 12 plus 1 is 13. So what is the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry? It is rupees 130. Okay. So now we are going to find out the total money paid by Honey. So for that we have to add the cost of 4 kgs of mangoes and cost of 2 boxes of strawberries. Okay. So what is the cost of 4 kgs of mangoes? It is 140, isn't it? So rupees 140 plus cost of 2 boxes of strawberries is rupees 130. So now add 140 plus 130. So add 0 plus 0 is 0. 4 plus 3 is 7. 1 plus 1 is 2. So how much money she paid? She paid rupees 270 rupees. Okay. Is it clear, children? Yes. Yes. So go through all the problems and practice at home, children. Okay. And be thorough with the multiplication tables. Okay. Then only you can do the problems very easily. Okay, children. Take care. Thank you.